How bad is depression? Well, according to one study, people who were perennially depressed saw increased health risks that were equivalent to a non-smoker taking up a pack-a-day habit. Essentially, depression is a death sentence. But fortunately, there's hope.
Life can be stressful. Whether you're facing a sudden illness, loss of a job, or the strain of a relationship, sometimes you just feel like giving up. Dutch Sheets is an internationally recognized pastor and author. His book, The Power of Hope, is a practical guide that will help you rise above life's disappointments and troubles.
Well, this is a book for everyone. Dutch Sheets is with us again. Always great to have you here.
Thank you. What a
great title, The Power of Hope. I mean, it's uplifting just to speak it. You talk about the scripture that says hope deferred makes the heart sick.
Right.
More than a scripture, it's real.
It is real, and I call hope deferred in the book the common cold of the soul. You can't go through life without experiencing hope deferred. Mm-mm. The loss of a loved one, an illness, a prayer you just knew would be answered.
Right.
You know, a setback, a financial setback. We all go through seasons of hope deferred. And if we don't get that under control quickly, it begins to erode our faith, and we become a heart-diseased patient.
Talk a little bit about your brother who had the occasion to watch an open-heart surgery.
One of the most amazing stories I've ever heard. He watched three of them. He stood literally at the head of the patient while they opened the patient and worked on the heart, and they disconnected the hearts while they worked on them, and a machine did the work. And then when they hooked it back up when they were finished, they had to get the heart going again. And the first two went just fine. And then he could tell something is wrong. They weren't telling him anything. He was just watching. Tension came into the room, and he realized something is wrong. And then he realized, they can't get this heart beating. I'm watching this person die. And finally, when they had exhausted all of their methods, the head surgeon leaned over to this obviously unconscious person and in her ear whispered, "Ma'am, I need your help. We can't get your heart to beat. Please tell your heart to beat again." And instantly, the heart began to beat.
Unbelievable.
And he just looked up and just kind of did this, and looked at all the people around the table, and went to work. And I've just, ever since, when I heard him tell the story, realized that's what we have to do.
Yeah.
When the dream is gone, when the setback, we feel like we've been punched in the stomach. Really, when our heart isn't beating anymore, we can't believe. We just have trouble surviving. There comes a point in time. We just have to choose. You know, healing from hope deferred starts with a choice.
Yeah.
It's not that we have to do it for ourselves, but we have to reconnect.
You have to say yes to it.
We have to say yes. We have to say, heart, you're going to believe again. Emotional heart, spiritual heart, you are going to believe again.
And yet there's a time to grieve and a time to hope. So how do you know when it's time?
Well, I think you probably need some help. I think all of us, some people have tried to say to me, "Can I give this book to so-and-so? They just lost a loved one." I say, no, don't give it to them yet.
Yeah.
They can't be expected to just jump out of their grief right now. Wait until the right time. Give a little time for godly grief and comfort.
Yeah.
You'll begin to see the signs. They begin to think differently. They begin to smile. That you can tell it's time to move on now. But it's not time to move on for the first few months after something tragic. So at the right time, you give them the book, or you give them the teaching, or you come alongside and say, "Come on, let's dream again. Let's do connect with God again here."
It's easy for us to lose hope in life. There are, as you said, so many things that happen to us. We're pretty hardwired as Americans, but the French have an interesting thing. They greet their expectant moms differently than we do here in America.
They do. You know, we tend to not want to mention the fact that the lady's pregnant.
Yes.
Might get a little awkward.
Yeah.
They greet a pregnant lady with the phrase, "I congratulate you on your hope."
Wow.
Because of the life that is growing inside of them.
Yeah.
Isn't that amazing? You know, one of the words for purpose in scripture is prothesis. It's easy to see prosthesis there.
Yeah.
Because, and it's in Romans 8:28. God calls us all things to work together, those called according to purpose. God calls us all things, even bad things, to work together for good. He puts in that verse the word prothesis, from which we get prosthesis, which is a new body part or a tooth or whatever that restores use. He's saying to us, I gave you a purpose. And when the enemy comes into your life and tries to steal your purpose, cut off that limb, whatever, I have already written into your thesis, prothesis.
Yeah.
Write the thesis in advance. I've already written how I'm going to restore that. Great.
It's fabulous. But I also know what it feels like when you've come to the end of yourself and the end of the line. How do you, when you've lost hope, how do you begin to regain it?
Well, the first thing is you have to reconnect with the Lord. Yeah. We draw near to Him in full assurance of faith. And as simple as it sounds, you have to start reconnecting to the source. First, you make the decision, but in that deciding time frame, you've got to go to the next step and say, am I willing to make more than a mental decision here? Will I reconnect? Mm-hmm. One of the examples I use in the book is Moses on the mountain. 40 years. He is the most classic case of hope deferred. 40 years on a mountain called Horeb, which means desolate. I mean, the very place he lived was a picture of his life.
Yeah.
Desolation and barrenness. And after 40 years, when God came to him and said, you thought I was finished with you, but I'm not finished with you. And this guy argued with God because there's no way. He had to come to a point, and God was patient, but God was firm, saying to him, come on, you're going to do this. And Moses would come back with this, and God would say, okay, we'll do this. And even when he said, well, I'm not a good speaker, okay, I'll give you some help. Aaron can go with you, but you are going to do this. I'm going to pull you out of this hope-deferred state. I'm not finished with you. We're going to get this done. Isn't that great?
You know, that's a word for us as individuals. It's a word for our country.
Yes, it is.
It's a word for America isn't it?
Absolutely. I am absolutely convinced God is not finished with America.
Amen.
I've been preaching a message about one of the flags we had in our early days. Before the Stars and Stripes, our nation was born under a flag that across the top said, an appeal to heaven.
Wow.
And there was an evergreen tree, which was a sign of covenant.
Yes.
They knew we can't defeat this empire without God's help. There's no way. George Washington literally commissioned this flag. It flew over all of our naval ships. It flew over Massachusetts, all the colonies, every battlefield when it was known. There's no way these upstart colonists can defeat the greatest empire in the world unless we really are in covenant with God, unless this is His idea, and He's for us. Mm. And if we appeal to heaven, it doesn't say appeal to our strength. It doesn't say appeal to the greatness of this people or this vision or anything else. It says appeal to heaven.
Let's resurrect that flag.
I'm telling you, I am. I'm carrying it all over the nation with me and telling the story. And it's exactly what Abraham did in Genesis 21:33. Yeah. He planted an evergreen tree, covenant. And he called on the everlasting God.
Amen. Dutch, you always bring a word of not just encouragement, but specific direction for us. And we so appreciate it. Listen, if you need, pick me up is too common a phrase. If you need hope in your life, get a copy of Dutch Sheets' book. It's called The Power of Hope. This is available in stores nationwide.